get their skin in a single piece every few days. Between the metallic and sapphire organisms like algae and hydroids. It has been estimated that millions of sea moths are collected each year to use in traditional Chinese medicine. This juvenile oriental flying gurnet deters predators by appearing as large as it can. The salt ice box on its pectoral fin makes it appear like a much larger fish than a buff. Like sea moths, gurnets also walk across the seabed on their pelvic fins. In adulthood, the pectoral fins become huge and lose most of their blue spots. They can be retracted for a burst of steam if necessary. It also gains more red around the face, which suits its alternative name of sea robin. Members of the family are also known as helmet gurnets because of the stronger armour surrounding them. The word gurnet is derived from the French word for grunt because of the strange sound that it makes. Over 700 species of fish are known as blennies, and some 400 of these are cone-shaped blennies. One such variety is the starry blenny, which usually lives among rocks where it feeds on algae. Its interesting appearance and strong personality may be popular in the aquarium trade. By far the largest kind of blend is the hair tail from snake blend. This blend can reach over half a metre long and borrows its body for the plan of a mouse to look like its snake's ears. It feeds at night and is rarely seen out of its burrow during the day. Gobies represent the world's largest fish family and one of the most varied. Yellow pygmy gobies are without doubt among the cutest. They are usually found in pairs and traditionally seek refuge in natural shelters such as empty shells. However, the many discarded bottles and cans in the street are very perfect home food. This female eggs and is clearly seen in her swollen belly. The gobies appear to exchange signals by prodding the other's tail. The pooty goby, a type of ghost goby, forms a commensal relationship with a variety of sessile invertebrates, sessile meaning immobile. Here it is living on a sea pen, a type of gorgonia. The sea pen receives neither benefit nor harm from the relationship, but provides the goby with shelter and a good spot to feed on plankton passing by in the current. These war-paint-like facial markings belong to a male fingered dragonette. Such benthic animals, creatures that live on the seabed, thrive in the muck of Lembe. The male has very long filamentous rays on his dorsal fin that it holds forward while moving. The first ray of the tail is effectively a mirror that extends from the dragonette's wings to walk along the seabed and dig for food, hence the name fingered dragonette. It feeds in a picky, methodical manner, similar to birds. The upper jaw can be thrust forward to catch prey such as small crustaceans. This motion reveals the female's bright orange of her lips. These orange-black dragonettes are similar and belong to the same genus. The distinctive juvenile is largely white in colour. effectively to light on the bottom. It is well camouflaged, and at night it would bury its body. The eyes and gills are placed high, so only they remain above the sand. A minuscule sea slug crawls down its dragonette. Thank you. hand and endowed you. The Etika resembles a polyphenic word. Black phase is a triated frogfish, without significant skin appendages, is sometimes seen. It's possible that the filaments may be seasonally shed. Lembe is famous for the amazing ability of the resident dive guides to spot special subjects. One of them found this tiny but perfectly formed juvenile painted frogfish crawling across the sand. The pointer behind it is just a quarter of an inch in diameter. It opened its mouth as a warning for a tiny nearby craft. The sheltered conditions make the strait a successful nursery, and juvenile fishes can be seen everywhere. This striking coloration belongs to a young spotted parrotfish. In later life, it will likely head out to more exposed reefs, where its few teeth will enable it to excavate chunks of hard coral. It will also undergo a dramatic change in coloration, as demonstrated by this mature male and species. The young feed on sediments lying on the reef. Nutrient-rich algae is digested, while the inert sand is excreted. Previously, all specimens bearing this pattern were thought to be of a species commonly known as the bicolour parrotfish, but those are now deemed to be local to the Red Sea. A starry goby takes this one by surprise. Sweetlings also change dramatically during their life cycle. This juvenile painted sweetling bears old stripes. As an adult, it loses the stripes and bears spots which will fade as it matures further. The juvenile harlequin sweetling mimics toxic flatworms and seaworms, and the movement is confusing for predators. As it matures, the movement slows down and the pattern starts to change. This adult individual from Thailand shows how it will end up. Juvenile yellow blotch razorfish, the type of wrasse, are here too. This fish will dive head first into the sand for food or if it is alarmed. The slim, bony head is optimized for this purpose. It prepares an area of sand in advance by loosening it to make it easier to dive into, and it is able to move significant distances under the sand before re-emerging. This white variation bears two false eye spots on its dorsal fin. Juvenile firefishes are a common sight too. Their retractable dorsal spine deters predators. The name firefish comes from the rough skin. It is said that dried firefish skin was once used like sandpaper to finish wooden boats. In Australia, they are known as leather jackets. This is a juvenile trapweed firefish. The adult is well camouflaged. This is a very young boxfish, possibly a long-horned